Greetings, my dear truth seekers. During negotiations with the Chinese Defense Minister, Sergei Shoigu declared that America's behavior poses a serious threat, and most likely this is another signal that Washington will have to consider, so to speak, the warning from Shoigu after the clear statements of Putin and Lavrov. The head of the Russian Minister of Defense, Sergei Shoigu, said that near the country's state border there is a significant increase in the activity of the strategic bomber aviation of the United States Air Force. This fact is attested by our military, said Shoigu. Experts drew attention to the fact that Sergei Shoigu made his statement during negotiations with his Chinese counterpart, Wei Fenghe. According to the Russian defense minister, the minimum distance for which American military aircraft approach the Russian border is only about 20 kilometers. At the same time, their exercises were aimed at practicing a nuclear strike against Russia. This month, during the exercise of the US Strategic Nuclear Forces, Global Thunder, 10 strategic bombers practiced the option of using nuclear weapons against Russia, almost simultaneously from the western and eastern directions. At this meeting, Sergei Shoigu also said that under conditions of growing geopolitical turbulence and an increase in conflict potential in different regions of the world, the development of cooperation between Russia and China, including defense, is becoming extremely relevant. It needs to be said that in the United States, the alliance between Russia and China is considered one of the biggest threats. Therefore, what Shoigu said will undoubtedly pay attention. Moreover, earlier clear signals were given by Russian President Vladimir Putin and Russian Foreign Minister Sergei Lavrov. Let me remind you that Vladimir Putin issued a warning to the United States at the end of last week. He stressed that NATO forces in the Black Sea area are behaving extremely arrogantly. The latest actions of NATO aviation are beyond safe limits. It should also be noted that Minister Sergei Lavrov is also working hard to solve this problem. On the eve, Lavrov made it clear that Russia is calling on the United States to start eye-to-eye talks on Donbas, now without intermediaries who interfere with the implementations of the Minsk agreements. Meanwhile, Chinese Defense Minister Wei Fenghe, during a working meeting with Russian Defense Minister Sergei Shoigu, spoke about the success of cooperation between the two countries. He stressed that fruitful work is being carried out in all areas. During this meeting, the Chinese defense minister stated that the entire world condemns America's actions. The United States is taking the same aggressive military actions and containment tactics against China as against Russia. The American side doesn't hide the conduct of the Cold War in a new form, said the Chinese defense minister. As a result of negotiations, Russia and China approved a roadmap for the development of military cooperation for 2021 to 2025. My friends, unfortunately, every day the tensions are increasing in the world. Let's hope that this will not lead to the start of the Third World War.